today I'm going to show you guys how to be a bride on a budget, and I'm going to show you a makeup tutorial that I've worked on for your big day. And I'm using all drugstore products, very affordable products. So if you're looking to save a little bit of money in the makeup department for your big day, then keep watching. And I'm going to show you guys how to do an awesome makeup look that's not only going to make you look beautiful, but feel beautiful for your big day. So let's get started. So you definitely want to start with your eyes, especially when you're going to be photographed on a big day, just so that there's no fallout underneath your eyes and it'll be picked up on camera. That being said, we're going to start, and for this entire look, I'm going to be using this Morphe 35W palette. This palette is really, really great. It has a lot of warm tones in it, and I believe that these would be so beautiful for a wedding day. So we are going to focus probably using this first and second row, and then selecting a couple of the darker brown shades. So first we're going to start with a base on our eyes. Normally I would use the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, but since we're trying to stay on a budget, you can use any type of not super thick concealer, and we're gonna just prime our eyelids with it. I'm using the NYX HD Concealer in the color Porcelain. It's the lightest shade. And I'm just going to put a tiny bit of that on my finger. And I'm just going to dab it on my eyelids. You don't need a lot. This is just going to prime and have a base for when you put your eyeshadow on. So that's all that that's doing. The first step after we primed our eyelids is we're going to just apply a light cream shade. I'm using this shade right here, and we're just going to apply that into your crease and bring it down onto the eyelid a little bit. I'm using the Morphe 433 brush. Again, we are just really building the color. So next I'm going to go with a slightly darker shade. This one has kind of a little bit of tone of pink. It looks pinker on the camera though, but it's still a beigey shade. I'm gonna use the same brush, and I'm gonna focus this again right into the crease. I'm trying not to get it above my lid. We don't want to smoke out this look too much. I'm also trying to keep it on the outer part of my lid, not going into the inner crease, because we want our eyes to look very open and wide for pictures. So that is the reasoning behind that. So next, with the same brush, I'm going to pull this light, light brown shade. It is also matte. All of the colors I've been using so far have been matte shades. We're going to do the same exact thing. Okay, so next I'm going to take my Morphe MB18 brush, and it's just a little bit more precise. As we get into darker colors, you want to really focus them into the crease. And I'm going to use this medium brown shade right here in the same palette, and we're going to apply that right into the crease. Use a little bit of product. You can always add more product, and you cannot take product away. And you definitely want to make sure that you're blending. This brush is really good for getting it right into the crease where it's supposed to go, but then you might want to go back in with another brush, either that you didn't use yet with no product on it, or one with a lighter shade, and just really blend it. Like I just said, I'm gonna go back in with the brush that I used the last time, and I am just going to blend that out. Next, I am going to go in with an even deeper shade. This one is going to have a bit of shimmer to it. It's this one right here, and it's a deeper brown shade. This is just going to create dimension in your crease, and I'm going to be using the Morphe MB27 brush, which is even more precise than the last brush, to really focus this into your crease. See those harsh lines right now? We want to blend it out again with the same brush. Blend, blend, blend. Going to go back in with another medium brown shade, this one right here, and it's going to have a little bit of shimmer in it. And we are going to apply this product on the outer V. Just keep applying the product and keep blending it out. All right, so that's that. Then with another brush, let's see, I'll go in with my Morphe G13. I'm going to go for kind of a light golden brown shade, this one right here. And I'm going to apply this on the inner part of my eye. I'm going to use a very light hand because I do not want it to get too dark. But I'm going to put it on the middle of my eye towards the inner corner right here. This is going to give me a little bit of shimmer and brighten up this inner eye. Just really blend because it will look like a harsh line in the middle of your eye because of all the dark shades that you've been applying to the outer part of your eye. So you definitely want to really blend. All right, so next I'm going to just take a small brush. I'm going to use the Morphe B16 brush. It's a very tiny brush. And that first shade that we use, that very, very light shade, I'm just going to use it and I'm going to put it on the nerd tear duct. This is just going to create a brightening effect and make your eyes look way wider and brighter. So next step is going to be to create a eyeliner on your upper lash line. And I would recommend for your wedding day to not use liquid liner or a harsh line. You really want it to be soft and romantic and beautiful looking. So what we're going to use is use a black shadow. And I'm going to spray my brush first with the NYX Matte Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. This is just going to wet the brush and have the eyeshadow stick to it a lot better than if we just didn't put anything on the brush. So just wet the brush a little bit. Any kind of a flat brush will be perfectly fine for this. And I'm using the same Morphe palette, see, just one palette for this entire look. And I'm going to use this matte black shade. There's also a matte shimmery shade, but for liner, we definitely want to stick with the matte black. So we just put a little bit of product on our eye and we're just going to dab it along the upper lash line. Don't worry if it's not straight, we're going to be blending this out. What this does is it just creates a It makes your lash line, your upper lash line, look way fuller, and also will disguise false lashes a lot better if you are going to wear false lashes. Okay, so the next step is to smudge the liner out. We want to keep the line thin on the inner part of our eye, and as we go out to the outside part of our eye, we want to smudge it up to kind of create a smoky look. But don't go too dramatic with this. Just keep it light. I'll show you guys. And then I'm just going to go back in with another brush and I'm just going to keep smudging it. So So if you are going to wear false lashes, now is the time to apply them. I would recommend putting a coat of mascara on your eyes first before you apply the false lashes. I'm going to be using, let's find it, this NYX La Chic Flick Waterproof Lashes. If you know you're going to cry on your wedding day, I would strongly recommend waterproof mascara. So I'm going to coat my lashes with this is the first step. Alright, so now that we have a coat of mascara on our eyes, I'm going to apply the glue to my lashes. I'm going to be using the Ardell Double Up Lashes. They're very dramatic for a wedding day. You don't have to wear false lashes, but your wedding day is the perfect opportunity and it definitely will make your eyes look more dramatic and beautiful. If you want to splurge on a product for your wedding day, I would highly recommend getting mink lashes, like velour lashes or something like that, because they will look more natural and they will last a long time. So they are a very good investment. So I would recommend to size your lashes to your eyes and cut from the middle, whatever doesn't fit your eye. So I'm going to just cut a little bit off of this. So after you get your false lashes on, you can go back in with the black shadow and just touch up any spots that need to be touched up. For a primer, I'm going to be using the primer, the Argan Wear Argan Oil with Coconut Water by Physicians Formula. You definitely have to pick a primer that is good for your skin type. So if you have oily skin, you don't want to pick a very oily primer. You might want to get a primer that helps mattify your face if you're very oily. If you have dry skin, you want to have a primer that doesn't dry out your skin. You want to have a primer with some moisture. I do recommend this one for dry skin. So I'm just going to spritz my face with this. I'm going to try to avoid my eye area. Primer is so great because it is so lightweight and it just sprays right on your face. So just let that dry and then we can get right in to the rest of the makeup look. Alright, so this is a step that can be skipped and this is a step that you can utilize to make your skin look better for your big day. I'm going to be color correcting my skin and this great little palette from Ulta comes with this little brush and it has 3, 4, 5 different correcting concealer shades. So you want to do this step before you apply your foundation or else you're gonna have colored skin. So I like this palette because it tells you what they do very basically. There's a yellow color that evens skin tone, redness corrector is the green, the purple brightens your skin, and then there's a light and a medium concealer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the yellow, and what the yellow is going to do is it's going to cancel out any, if you have any dark circles under your eye, and it's just going to really brighten underneath your eyes. I would recommend this definitely for underneath your eyes. Also an orange kind of color, darker orange, is going to help correct that as well. So I'm just going to put this underneath my eyes. Next, if you have any red, if you have any pimples or anything like that, you want to use the green. I do have a little bit of redness right up here, so I'm going to apply that right there, and a little bit of redness right here on my nose. Not sure why, a little bit of redness right here. And then I'm going to go back in with the purple shade, and if you have any discoloration, yellow tone skin, overly yellow, then the purple is going to cancel that out. But I'm just going to show you guys and brighten up my cheeks a little bit. So I'm gonna put that right under my yellow. And I'm just going to be using this Real Techniques sponge that I got. It's awesome. This is the first sponge besides an actual beauty blender that I've really liked. The consistency is awesome. It gets really big when you wet it, and it also has this flat edge right here. Can you see that? And that's really great for getting in under your eyes. So I definitely recommend these sponges. Sponges are great because it doesn't pack on the makeup so thick. This will be great for your wedding day if you apply it with a sponge, because it gives you kind of that light look. It doesn't really like pack it on so you look like cake face. So I am just going to blend all of this in. So you don't want to wipe this because then it's just going to all disappear. You're just really dabbing it in so that it soaks into the skin. Just like that, and you're gonna still see the color through it, but don't worry, when you apply the foundation, it is going to completely hide it. So next step is going to be the foundation. I'm using L'Oreal Paris True Match Lumi Cushion. It's a buildable luminous foundation, and this is in the color C3. This foundation is awesome. There is a ton of drugstore foundation that you can use for your wedding day that is going to look absolutely stunning. The one thing that you need to look for is that it is a low SPF or a no SPF foundation. SPF is going to cause oil to come through to your skin, make you shiny, and it could also cause you to break out, etc. So definitely an oil-free, SPF-free foundation. So this is a great option. Comes with like a little sponge, so I'm just going to dip this end of my sponge right into the foundation, and I'm going to just do a dab on each part of my face. You can actually dip a brush in here as well, just to get the foundation out, whatever floats your boat. So once that's on your face, you just want to dab it in. You also want to make sure that you bring it down your neck, just so that it blends out very naturally and it doesn't look like you have a harsh line here. So next step is going to be concealer, and I know that that sounds a little bit repetitive, but we're going to just brighten up our under eye and add a little extra layer of concealer if I can find it. And I'm going to use the same concealer that I primed my eyelids with. This is the NYX HD Concealer in the color Porcelain. So I'm going to use the wand that it comes with, and I'm going to just apply this right under my eye, and then I'm going to do a line down my nose and just up to the top of my forehead. This is just going to brighten up that area. And then I'm going to just blend it in. All right, so when that's all blended, it's time to contour. You can also skip this step, but this is a very important step for me. I love contouring. So my favorite product, cream contour product, is the True Match Super Blendable Crayon Concealer. This works so good, and I got it in the color medium deep, and you can draw right with it because it's a crayon. Mine has like a dull end, but I just use the edge of it, and we're going to just contour our face. So what I do is I draw a line right here to bring my forehead in a little bit. I go right under my cheekbone, right there, a line right along my jaw, a line under my lower lip to create a more plumper look, and then I will also contour my nose. This is the part that needs to be a little bit more precise, so take your time with it. So So just like that. And so I'm going to use the same sponge to blend this out, and then I'm going to show you how I blend out my nose. So let's start with this. You want to make sure that your contour is like a heart shaped like this. You don't want to go in this heart shape minus your nose, but you want to make sure that this part of your face is very light and this part is darker. This is going to create a very even looking face, and it's just going to transform your look. The key is to really blend though. You definitely don't want any dark, harsh lines, because that will very, very easily be picked up on camera. So for my nose, what I usually do first is I will blend it with my finger. So I kind of dab it down to the side of my nose. I make sure not to get it on the center, and I will just start to bring it down like that. And then I'll go back in with the sponge once it's kind of blended out already and just continue blending. You can also do this with a brush if you don't think you're gonna be very precise with the sponge. So, just like that. So now it's time to set your face. On your wedding day, you definitely probably want to set your face with powder. Not only is this going to help mattify it, but it's going to keep oils at bay and really just make your face stay and stay put. So there's a couple of options. This is a little bit more of an expensive option. It is the Ben Nye Luxury Powder. It's in, it's the banana powder, and it's yellow. And I'm going to use this underneath my eyes. It's not that expensive, but you want to definitely practice with your powders, because there's a lot of powders out there that have flashback. And if you guys have ever seen photos with flashback, it's not a very pretty sight. Another go-to powder for me is this Airspun Loose Face Powder. For me, it doesn't have flashback. I do only use a very tiny bit of it. So far, this powder has worked very well for me. So I'm just actually gonna use this. So I just dip my beauty blender right into it, and I'm going to focus on the under eye because I really want this to stay in put. So I'm going to put some powder right on that. This is where I would be putting my Ben Nye banana powder if I wanted to go that route, but today I'm just going to put this powder. As you can tell, it's already mattifying my face like crazy. So we're going to dab under the eye. I'm going to dab my nose to keep that contour in place. And then my forehead. And I'm not using a lot of powder. I'm really not. I'm really making it go a long way. But this is really gonna help to set your face. And if you notice that you have a little bit of excess powder on your face and the sponge isn't really getting rid of it, just get a big fluffy brush and just kind of lightly fluff your face. Fluff your face. Just to get any excess powder off of you. Next step is to bronze. I'm using the Milani Baked Bronzer in the color Soleil. And I'm just going to apply it to this Morphe G3 brush, and I'm just going to put that right over where I contour. This is just going to give a light golden kind of look. It's gonna make you look like you're glowing. Then following that, I'm going to apply my blush. I'm using the Milani Baked Powder blush in the color Luminoso. I'm going to put a little bit onto my Morphe M405 brush, and I'm going to apply it right on the apples of my cheeks. A little trick with blush is it soaks into your skin throughout the day. So if you go a little bit overboard in the beginning, it will probably, by the time you're having your wedding, look perfect. So I'm gonna go a little bit overboard on it right now. Just like that. Following that, we're going to apply a highlighter. Two of my favorite highlighters, drugstore highlighters, are the L'Oreal Paris True Match Lumi Powder Glow Illuminator Highlight, and I believe that there's two different colors, but it's this one. It's very light and it's very beautiful. But what I'm going to use today is my Goddess of Love Triple Baked Highlighter. It's from Makeup Revolution. This highlight is just so soft, and on your wedding day, you don't want to use a very strong highlight. I would not recommend that because it's going to cause flashback to the camera. This is a perfect highlighter. There's also one, what is it called? It's my Hourglass, it's my favorite Hourglass highlight. And I will link it down below what the name of the color is. But if you are going to splurge on one item for your wedding day, it should be this highlighter. It is pretty expensive, but honestly, it makes you look like you're glowing from within. You look so stunning, but I must say this highlight does a very similar thing. It's a very soft highlight. So I'm going to put this on my brush and I'm going to apply it right on the tops of my cheekbones. And I'm not gonna go overboard with this. I'm just putting it right on the top of where I applied my blush. It's just going to create a really soft glow. And then what I'm going to do is apply a little bit onto, if I can find a brush, onto a small brush. I'm using the Morphe B16 brush, and I'm just going to put a little bit onto my nose. This is just going to make that contour of your nose like stand out. You definitely can skip this step, but I like to do it. So, just gives an extra little glow. So, last but not least, well, not really last but not least, but I'm going to do my eyebrows. The reason that I waited to do my eyebrows is because you definitely want to do it before you, after you put your foundation on. You could totally do it before you do the highlighter and the blush and stuff, but this is when I like to do my brows. So I am using the NYX Micro Brow Pencil in the color Taupe. This pencil is a total dupe for the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz pencil in the color Taupe. So this is an awesome drugstore option. Another huge thing for your wedding is to set your eyebrows. And I know you're like, wait, what? Set my eyebrows? So I know that this isn't a drugstore product, but they do have drugstore versions of this. I just don't have one, and I'm sorry. It's a brow wax. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Beauty Express for Brows and Eyes little palette. And I'm just going to use my finger and apply just some of this wax right onto my brows. And all this is going to do is keep my brows from moving around all day. So this is awesome if you have long brow hairs or you just really don't want to worry about your brow being like all over the place, you know what I mean? But they make clear eyebrow gel in like a mascara wand tube at the drugstore. I used to have one, but mine got like really dirty because they get really dirty if you put product on your eyebrows, the product gets into it. So I would highly recommend picking one of those up before your big day, because that's going to keep your eyebrows in place, and then you can just kind of brush them and ta-da, they'll be in place like this for the rest of the day. So lip color on your wedding day is a complete decision that you need to make on your own. It's a complete personal opinion, and a lot of people don't even want to wear lipstick on their wedding day. My thought to you though is to definitely wear something, but wear something that is very nude, sheer. Any of the MAC satin lipsticks are great. This NYX lip butter is amazing. I have it in this color and I have it in this one. So this pink one is West Coast. and this one is called Pops right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix the two of these, but first I'm going to line my lips. And I'm going to line my lips with this lip liner. It's by Italia and it's the natural beige color. I got these on Amazon and honestly these are the best lip liners that I've ever used. What I do is I fill them in as well. Any nude kind of lip liner will work great. Something that almost matches the color of your lips. So, this one is a great color. First, I'm going to be using this color, West Coast. Some people might like this color, it's just a little bit pink for me. And I'm just going to apply this in the color Pops right on top. Oh, wait a minute. I forgot to do my lower eyelashes. What am I doing? You guys, I forgot to do my lower lash line. Let me zoom you back in again. That's no good. This step is super easy, so no worries. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a flat brush. This one is by Morphe, it's the B75 brush. And I'm going to take that same palette that we used, the Morphe 35W palette, and I'm going to just take this deep brown shade down here. So I'm just going to take a deep brown shade like I showed you, and I'm just going to pack it in my under eye. We're just trying to smoke this look out a little bit just so that our lower lash line matches our upper. Okay, so next in my waterline, I'm going to line it with this nude NYX Wonder Pencil. You can also use a white eyeliner pencil. What this is going to do is brighten up your eyes, even though we did just put a little bit of smoky color down there. This is going to make your eyes look brighter, so just line your waterline with this. Next step would be to put mascara on your lower lash line. This is totally up to you. Some people don't want to do this. I'm actually one of those people that don't normally like putting mascara on my lower lash line just because it transfers under my eyelid very easily. But waterproof mascara doesn't, so I'm just going to apply a light layer of this. So also, one step that I didn't film was after I was done doing my eyelashes, I wiped underneath my eyes with a makeup wipe. This step is going to be crucial to removing any fallout on your face, even if you didn't see it. So I'm sorry you guys, I didn't film that, but I just quickly wiped with a makeup wipe and I could see all the fallout that I had. So that had my face become fresh and ready to put the primer on it. So that was the step that I took right before I applied the primer. So the final step of this look is to apply a makeup setting spray. This is the NYX Matte Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. You don't want to skip this step. There are so many setting sprays out there that you can buy. This one is very, very affordable from a drugstore. They also sell it at Ulta or wherever they sell NYX products. So I'm just going to spray my face with this. And then you just let it dry. What this is going to do is it's going to seal in your makeup, make it glue to your face, and it's not going to move for the entire day. So this is perfect for an event like a wedding. All right, so this is my finished Bride on a Budget makeup look. I hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial. This makeup look can be used for anybody going to any kind of a special occasion, whether it's a wedding, whether you're the bride, the maid of honor, whatever, even if you're just attending the wedding and you want your makeup to last all day, this makeup look is just perfect for that. So I hope that you guys enjoyed it. It's very light and flirty and just perfect for your big day. So I hope that you guys like this video and I will see you all soon. Bye!